Hey, what's going on? It's Eddie for Watch Before You Buy, and today we are looking at the Tinwoo smartwatch. Today is 8 November 2021, and the price of the smartwatch is $80. The watch comes in black and evening with black colors. This is how the box looks like, and in the box beside the watch you will find a charging cable and the user manual. The watch has 1.3 inch screen. On the right side it has three buttons, while on the other side in the middle we can see sensors and magnetic charging pins. Beside the magnetic charging, the watch also supports wireless charging. The straps are made out of TPU materials and its width is 22 millimeters. You can easily exchange them thanks to the quick release mechanism. The watch weight is 50 grams without the straps and 66 grams with. To see the watch face, turn the wrist, or you can also press any of the buttons. When you turn the wrist or press the button, the watch face will stay visible for 12 seconds by default, and it can be prolonged by 3 or 5 seconds. You can schedule disable lift wrist to see, and you also have an option of always on display. The watch can also detect when you're not looking at the watch and put it on the standby automatically. Pressing the upper button will toggle on and off the watch. Pressing the middle button will take you to the stopwatch and timer app, while pressing the lower button will take you to the fitness app, where you have 8 sport modes. This is how the running sport mode looks like. When the sport mode is active, swiping up will take you to the media controller, where you can control your media on the phone. Tap on the back icon to stop the sport mode. While on the watch face, if you tap on the weather icon, it will take you to the weather app, where you have your current temperature and maximum and minimum for that day. We also have here things like the time of the sunrise, sunset, wind speed and more. Swipe right to go to the activity app. Here you have your step, distance and calories spent on this day. If you tap on one of them, you'll see detailed data showing you when did you make those steps. If you swipe right again, it will take you to the last screen where you have your heart rate app, where you can measure your heart rate. The watch will also measure your heart rate automatically every 30 minutes. The next app shows you your sleep data. Here you have your overall sleep time with deep and light sleep. While on the watch face, if you swipe up, it will take you to the quick access menu where you have your eco battery mode, which will disable certain features to expand the battery life. Then we have Don't Disturb, which will disable notifications. Below that is the music controller and Find My Phone feature. This feature will use your Bluetooth connection to find your phone and make it ring. While on the watch face, swipe down to go to the notifications. Here you see your missed calls and messages. This is how it looks when someone calls you. You have an option to end the call. This is how it looks when someone sends you a message via internet. The watch will vibrate and show you the message. And when someone calls you via internet, the watch will not show it until the call ends. Then you will get the notification of missed call. While on the watch face, if you swipe to the left, here you have your sport modes. We already saw this. This app is attached to the lower button. Then we have the breathing relaxation app. Next is the stopwatch and counter app. This app is attached to the middle button. And the last thing here is the settings. Here on the first place we have the watch face controls. So if you tap on this first icon here, you'll be able to change the watch face. You have 13 watch faces altogether. If you tap on this icon here, your watch face will be changed every day automatically. And the last icon will allow you to change your watch face by shaking your wrist. After that we have 3 levels of brightness. And we can also increase our watch face visibility here. If you swipe up, we have here about restore and power off. And with this, we are done with the watch. Now let's check the app quickly. On the first page, we have all of our data here. So if you tap on, let's say, heart rate, you can see your heart rate automatic measurements. If you go to the sleep data, we can see here more detailed data. And that's the case for everything else here. Now let's go to the settings. Here we have take photo feature, so you can control your phone front and back camera with the watch. If you go to the device, here we have all the standard things like from which apps would you like to get notifications. Alright, now with this we are done with the watch. And the app, the only thing left is to do some testing, so let's do that. The first test is Raise to Wake feature. This test demonstrates the speed of your hand movement detection. The watch response can be sometimes a little bit slow, but overall I would say it works good. When it comes to the screen, you can see it has really good viewing angles. The touch responsiveness is really good. This is definitely one of the better screens you can get on a budget smartwatch. When it comes to the transitions, they are quite fast. I didn't see any lag or anything similar. When it comes to the screen brightness, this is how the screen looks on a daylight with a brightness of level 1, and this is how it looks on the brightness on level 3, which is maximum. When it comes to Find My Phone feature, what I found is that if your phone is in the visibility line, you can easily detect it from the distance of 100 feet or 30 meters. I've also managed to detect my phone in another room through a thin wall. The next test I did was an alarm vibration test. I wanted to see if the vibration is strong enough to kick you out of the sleep. And what I found is that the vibration is not that strong, but of course this test is subjective, so I would emphasize that you set your important alarms with your phone and not rely only on the watch. When it comes to the step counter, I did 3 tests. In the first one, I did 100 steps and the watch recorded 101 steps. In the second test, I did 500 steps and the watch recorded 503 steps. While in the third test, I did 1000 steps, where the watch recorded 1001 step. When it comes to the battery test, I couldn't do a proper test as all battery information I have is this icon here, but from what I saw, it looks like you can get a week of battery life on normal use. Charging time takes about 2 hours. Tinwoo smartwatch comes with IP67 resistance rating, which means that it has dust and sand resistance, and that it was tested for water resistance by putting it at least under the water for 30 minutes in the depth up to 1 meter. I did my 30 minutes underwater test and the watch has passed the test. To test the heart rate app, I'll be using the pulse oximeter. I did 7 different tests in the span of a few days and here are my results. 5 out of 7 tests were correct. And with this, I'm pretty much done with all of my tests. I hope you have enjoyed watching this video. And as always, if you have any questions, please leave a comment in the comment box below. Thank you for watching again. Have a nice day and catch you guys later.